Hello, my name is Aiden Petersen. I'm a freshman in computer engineering, and I decided to do my research on John Atanasoff. Obviously, I love computers. Thought it would be a cool thing to research John Atanasoff, as he was the creator of the first electrical computer at Iowa State University. Okay, so before I get into all of Atanasoff's work and cool things about him, I'd like to talk about my experience with the archives. I had a great time. It was super cool. I got to research a bunch of documents, especially this amazing one on screen right here. Interesting. But you had a great time. There are so many documents I couldn't find anywhere else. It was awesome. Okay, so before John Atanasoff made his Atanasoff Berry computer, he worked as a researcher at Iowa State University. So he actually modified a IBM tabulator machine so that he could do specific calculations with it. I thought this was really interesting. I found this information from a outline by this guy named Mollenhoff, who was a Des Moines Register columnist. And he really liked writing about Atanasoff and all of his work. And he wrote a biography about him that was a pretty big deal, I think. He was a Pulitzer Prize winner. So I found this information in an outline, and then later, in the outline, it said that he wrote a paper, but he couldn't find the paper in the outline. Like, he said he couldn't find the paper, so I just, like, looked up the paper, found it on the archives website. It was pretty cool. Okay, so now onto Atanasoff's computer. So he made the first electrical computer, meaning that it used binary or meaning it used electrical logic instead of mechanical logic like the IBM tabulator that he was using before. It meant that, it really set the foundation for the future of all of the computers to come after, as using electrical components is much simpler, and it also is quite a bit faster, too. So, Atanasoff actually had an assistant when he was building his computer named Clifford Berry. He was a graduate student at the time, and he just helped him out with the building of the computer. So the computer was a pretty simple, pretty kind of primitive. It was able to really solve only one kind of problem, which was systems of linear equations. It could solve up to systems of 29 linear equations, which was definitely useful at the time, because it's not easy to solve systems of 29 linear equations, because it just takes forever. But it was definitely built for that specific problem, and it couldn't do anything else. So one of the other big outcomes of his computer, it used binary logic instead of like base 10 or other sort of systems of holding numbers. So I used binary, base 2, ones and zeros, and then it was able to convert that into base 10, where it output onto a punch card using a cool base 2 to base 10 wheel thing they had in the machine. Okay, so one of the more interesting things I found while researching John Atanasoff was he was involved in a court case called Honeywell v. Rand, which was a court case between the company Sperry Rand and the other company, Honeywell. So Sperry Rand was suing Honeywell because they believed that they infringed on their patent to the ENIAC, which they bought from John Mockley. So in the court case, it was actually ruled that it was derived from the ABC, and Atanasoff actually got co-founder status on the patent, which was a very cool turn of event. He actually got paid pretty well by Honeywell. I got to read some cool secret documents, and it actually showed that he got paid a good chunk of change for participating with Honeywell as a consultant, which was pretty cool. Okay, so on to my sources. I used a bunch of papers from the John Vincent Atanasoff collection, which obviously has a bunch of papers about John Vincent Atanasoff. There's a bunch of cool stuff in there, from things that reporters like Mollenhoff wrote about him to all of the different research and papers that he did. I only was able to go through 3 boxes, but there were so many, which so much information that I missed out on. I also used a box from the Henry L. Hansen collection, which was about a patent clerk who worked for the corporation division, and he worked on the Honeywell v. Sperry Rand case, so I was able to get a bunch of information about that case through that one box.